Rick Van Hoos will have full commitment 2010 coverage on the Indiana primary for you. Be sure to watch the bottom of your screen for the races of importance to you.
You could call it a Hoosier hysteria tonight as the Republican primary for the 9th District U.S. House seat produces a three-way race to the wire. 28-year-old Travis Hankins of Bloomington, attorney Todd Young and former Congressman Mike Sodrel have all been within a few percentage points of each other all night. With 99% of the vote in, Young has 34% of the vote, Hankins 32%, Sodrel 31%. Andy Alcock is live at Sodrel campaign headquarters in Sellersburg. Andy, a surprise there.
Vicki and Rick, clearly it is, and only a handful of people are still here at Cricket's Cafe in Sellersburg. Sodrel conceded he was not going to win the race at about 9:15 this evening, and tonight it appears the former congressman's political career is over.
You know, there's been a big anti-incumbent mood in the country, and I was painted as an incumbent by some folks because I had served one term in Congress.
Former Congressman Mike Sodrel was looking for answers tonight after falling short in his bid for a fifth straight Republican nomination for Indiana's 9th District U.S. House seat. This morning, Sodrel was all smiles as he voted.
We're looking forward to it.
How did this three-way race materialize? Part of it had to do with money. Travis Hankins raised more than $183,000, just $20,000 less than Sodrel at $203,000. Sodrel says Hankins targeted counties in the northeast part of the district, near his home base in Columbus, and also garnered Tea Party support.
I have to congratulate the young man. He planned his work. He worked his plan. He's worked hard on grassroots, been at it 2 years since election night of 08, and he should be congratulated.
Sodrel also acknowledges he made a tactical decision which may have cost him the race. 2 weeks ago, his internal polling showed him winning easily. But in the last 2 weeks, Sodrel says Young threw about $250,000 at the race, mostly targeting Sodrel in a negative way. Young raised more than $473,000, more than double what Sodrel raised. All three men's campaigns were almost entirely funded with their own money. Sodrel decided not to spend more of his funds at the end.
Hindsight is always 20/20. We were up far enough that we thought we could stand the beating we were taking in the last 2 weeks.
Sodrel says he'll support the party's nominee against incumbent Barron Hill, who Sodrel says can no longer call himself a blue dog Democrat after voting for the stimulus $800 billion package, cap and trade, and the health care bill.
I think Speaker Pelosi ran an obedience school for the blue dog Democrats and taught them how to roll over.
And WLKY tonight, right now, is calling this race for Bloomington attorney Todd Young, who apparently has eked it out over Travis Hankins and Mike Sodrel. Barron Hill, the congressman who is currently holding the seat, easily won the Democratic primary tonight, outpacing four mainly unfunded opponents. As for Sodrel, he says he can never say never, but he says it's unlikely he'll run for political office again. Reporting live at Sodrel campaign headquarters in Sellersburg, Andy Alcock, WLKY News.